Thanks for checking in with Maine's Total Weather on this eve before a big storm. Calm out there tonight. Clouds will increase and seasonally cold temperatures back down into the teens. If you've got errands to run, no problems whatsoever. It's not until tomorrow that the nor'easter arrives, and here's the breakdown of it. Marine storm warnings have been posted along the coastal waters. We are looking at heavy snow overspreading the area. I think we'll see close to a foot of snow before all is said and done. But it's the wind which I really think will make the headlines, gusting close to 50 miles per hour, and that means blowing and drifting snow, and unfortunately the possibility of power outages late tomorrow afternoon into the evening. Coastal flooding also a concern. We've got a high tide midday tomorrow. Coastal flood warnings have been issued for York and Cumberland County. So a lot of weather to go through here. Storm system is now taking shape off the southeastern Atlantic shoreline and continuing to strengthen, expected to take a path which, you know, stays offshore. This is not going to be a direct hit on New England, and then curves up onto the west side of Nova Scotia and up toward the Bay of Fundy, all the time strengthening into a powerful nor'easter. And in doing so, what we're going to expect here, you can see on the timeline, is snow to overspread the area during the morning tomorrow. So first thing in the morning, probably not a big deal, but by lunchtime we've got snow coming down, and the intensity coupled with the wind producing poor visibility, possibly leading to blizzard conditions during the afternoon into the evening. Storm then lifts out Friday morning. It's still windy on the backside, clouds and snow showers, but the worst of the storm will be over and the cleanup will be underway. Snowfall amounts, I'm thinking about a foot, Portland, back toward the lakes region. There may be some areas that exceed a foot, get up into the mountains, perhaps closer to 10 inches. And talking about exceeding a foot, 14 to 18 inches running out toward the northern reaches of Penobscot Bay and folks down east. Wind is also going to be a factor with this storm system. Sustained winds close to 30 miles per hour, but wind gusts may approach 50 miles per hour. And that is why we're concerned about the blowing and drifting and the power outages here late tomorrow. 8-day forecast. Let's hope we can keep the power outages to a minimum, because it is going to be very cold here on Saturday.